GOP Senator Lindsey Graham is taking his defense for President Trump to new levels this morning. In a lengthy interview with our Becky Anderson, Graham says that he's already made up his mind on impeachment. And he says that he plans to vote to acquit the president in the Senate, even though the trial hasn't even started yet. Watch.
I don't know where this goes, but I know impeachment will be over soon. I supported the Mueller investigation, by the way, for those who care about domestic politics. I didn't know what Trump had done with the Russians. What have I come to believe? There is no collusion between the Trump campaign and the Russians. If you're not colluding with your own government, why do you think you're colluding with the Russians? The president's not much of a colluder. So the bottom line here is that Mueller spent 2 years and $25 million looking at all things Trump and Russia, and now we're impeaching the president of the United States, bipartisan people, no outside counsel involved. This thing will come to the Senate, and it will die quickly, and I will do everything I can to make it die quickly.
I just wonder how quickly. Let's do a little bit on procedure. There's a debate ongoing about how a trial should be held in the Senate, including whether to have live witnesses. You don't support live witnesses. Why?
I want this to end as quick as possible for the good of the Senate, for the good of the country. And I think the best thing for America to do is get this behind us. We know how it's going to end, so we can focus on the problems we talked about today. If you don't like President Trump, you can vote against him in less than a year. It's not like a politician is unaccountable if you don't impeach him. So I think impeachment is going to end quickly in the Senate. I would prefer it to end as quickly as possible. Use the record that was assembled in the House to pass impeachment articles as your trial record. I don't want to call anybody. I don't need to hear from Hunter Biden. I don't need to hear from Joe Biden. We can deal with that outside of impeachment. I don't want to talk to Pompeo. I don't want to talk to Pence. I want to hear the House make their case based on the record they established in the House, and I want to vote.
So joining me now to talk about all of this is Reuters White House correspondent Jeff Mason and CNN political commentator and Washington Post assistant editor David Swerdlick. Thank you both for joining us.
Hey, Mark.
David, let me start with you. Your reaction to Graham here, especially, you know, he is saying he doesn't want any witnesses, and yet, of course, we know when all of this was taking place in the House, Republicans were demanding witnesses of their own.
Right. Good morning, Martin. So I think on the one hand, give Senator Graham credit for laying out the facts as they basically are. Mm-hmm. Most Republicans have made up their minds in the Senate and in Congress generally. Most Republicans in the Senate seemingly want to make this short. And most Republicans have gone with this line that there's an election in less than a year, so why are we even bothering with this? He's not wrong on all of those points. On the other hand, it is jarring to see someone who is voting in a Senate trial, a constitutional legal proceeding, essentially saying that before the proceeding even takes place, he's already made up his mind. And I will just note on that whole thing about there being an election in less than a year. Nothing in the Constitution says that impeachment only applies in years 1 through 3 of a presidential term. It just says that the Senate has the sole power to try all impeachments.
Mm-hmm. And Jeff, to David's point there, let's listen to what Graham had to say about whether or not he's being appropriate by stating his opinion ahead of this trial. Watch.
But you are, along with the rest of your Senate fellows, jurors. Is it appropriate to be voicing your opinion even before this gets to the Senate as a trial?
Well, I must think so, because I'm doing it.
So I'm wondering, Jeff, what do you make of this kind of demeanor? It seems to be a total abrupt affront to this whole impartiality thing.
Well, he's certainly not holding back with that answer to Becky.
No.
You know, I think Republicans and to some extent Democrats have viewed this process as partisan. Certainly more Republicans are seeing it as partisan. Democrats have said that they're doing this because they're supporting impeachment because of their need to fulfill their constitutional responsibilities. Republicans see it as a partisan issue. The president has dismissed it as a witch hunt and as a sham, which he did yesterday in the Oval Office. And Senator Graham, I guess, is just saying, look, we've seen the evidence. We disagree that this has led to impeachment, and I've already made up my mind. He will be open to some criticism for having said that, but I don't think it's a big surprise that Senator Graham's position on this is that President Trump will be acquitted in the Senate. And if you look at the numbers, it's not hard to draw that conclusion even without Senator Grant's comments.
But don't senators take an oath when this proceeding begins that they swear to be impartial? Won't he be breaking that oath?
I mean, certainly they take an oath, and it's not for me to say whether he'd be breaking it or not. But I think if you look broadly at how this has gone over the last couple months, the Democrats and the Republicans are very sharply divided. It does not look like there will be any Republicans supporting the impeachment vote in the House next week. And once we get to the Senate trial, where the president is expecting to have a much friendlier audience because the Senate is controlled by Republicans,
sure,
it is likely to continue to be partisan in that same way.
And as we pointed out here, David, the Republican Party has rallied around this president to defend him in an almost unprecedented way. What do you think the long-term effects are going to be on the GOP party beyond this administration?
Well, just in terms of impeachment, I think we could get to a point as the Democratic race heats up in 2020 where this is already in the rearview mirror. Democrats will likely vote to impeach on Wednesday. There will be a Democratic debate Thursday night. Then we'll have the holidays, the Senate trial. Presumably, Republicans want it to be short, maybe 2 weeks. We don't know, and that obviously could change. But once you get into the Iowa caucuses and beyond, I do think eventually people will move on from this, not because they'll forget, but because there will be a campaign afoot and because the president won't be removed. As Jeff said, there's no Republican votes that anybody is aware of in the House for impeachment, and I'm skeptical that there are Republican votes for removal in the Senate. So as time goes on, this will have been an intense chapter, but one that probably ultimately doesn't change the entire landscape.
So, Jeff, instead of calling witnesses to either defend or refute the charges that have been made against this president, it seems that the Senate wants to rush through this. So what? That hopefully voters will forget all about it come next fall?
Well, a couple different answers to that question. Number one, I don't think that's 100% clear yet. I mean, I was in the Oval Office with the president yesterday when we asked for his reaction to the vote in the committee, and he went on to say, we went on to ask him as well how he felt about a long trial versus a short one, and he said, I'll do whatever I want. And he said he saw some value in having a longer trial because he'd like to put on witnesses like the whistleblower. So, but he also specifically mentioned he had seen what Senator Graham had said and was taking all of that into account as well. So we'll see. But broadly, I think it's correct to say that certainly some senators would like to just get this done quickly and move on.
Jeff Mason, David Sverdlick, thank you both for being on the program today.
Thanks, Martin.